this video, we will look at rate laws that are typically used in large-scale models, such as the global carbon cycle model. We will see that the fluxes in large-scale models are described by first-order kinetics with respect to the size of the source. This is because they represent the effects of many different processes averaged over long timescales, which are assumed to be limited by the source. We explain this rate law on a very crude model of the global carbon cycle, consisting of only two compartments, the atmospheric CO2 and the surface biosphere. The productivity by the biosphere on our planet varies greatly, depending on the location as well as the seasonal variation. However, when we take the average across the entire globe and over the entire year, we can assume that the transfer of carbon from the atmosphere to the biosphere is proportional to the size of the atmospheric CO2 pool. This means that on the global and annual scale, the biosphere elements, such as plants, are not limiting this transfer, but it is the atmospheric CO2 that limits biomass production. Similarly, we can assume that on the global and annual scale, the transfer of carbon from the biosphere to the atmosphere via respiration is proportional to the size of the biosphere. This is reasonable because oxygen is always present and is therefore not limiting respiration. We see that in both cases, the fluxes of carbon are assumed to be linearly proportional to the size of the source compartment. These rate laws are therefore similar to the first-order kinetics used to describe the rates of elementary chemical reactions. Specifically, they assume that the source compartment is the rate-limiting factor. We emphasize, however, that these rate laws are reasonable approximations of process rates only in models that describe systems on large spatial scales and long timescales. In these types of models, the sizes of the compartments and of the fluxes between the compartments can sometimes be well constrained. For example, in our crude carbon cycle model, the amount of carbon in Earth's atmosphere is about 590 petagrams, whereas the size of the biosphere is about 2300 petagrams of carbon. Furthermore, the annual exchange of carbon between the atmosphere and the biosphere is about 60 petagrams carbon per year. These values can now be used to calculate the rate constant for the carbon fluxes between the atmosphere and the biosphere. Specifically, using the rate laws presented earlier, the rate constant for the global productivity is about 0.1 per year, whereas the rate constant for the global respiration is about 0.026 per year. Using these values, we can therefore develop a fully quantitative model and study the effects of the global scale perturbations such as deforestation and burning of fossil fuels. You will do this in one of the exercises. Afterwards, you will make the model more realistic by including more compartments and study the effects of these perturbations as part of your homework assignment.